Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name's Jim Beckler. We just took in a really nice motorhome. I'd like to take a few minutes to show you. It's a 2003 Tradewinds by National RV. It's a 7391 model. So this is a double slide, nice roomy floor plan. We'll take a look inside here in just a minute as soon as we go through the outside a little bit. You may have questions sometime during the video. Feel free to give me a call at 541-510-1017. Maybe I'll miss something that you'll think about, or you just want to get a hold of me for whatever reason. Obviously, I'd appreciate if you call me if you do have questions. So for starters, this unit is full body paint. So it's got the nice decor, nice paint on the outside. You can see it's really standing tall. This has been kept inside when it hasn't been out on the road. So it's paint's been preserved very well. You can see it doesn't have a lot of fading or any problems in that regard. Lots of storage in this motorhome. If you look along the side, you can see it does have a nice big awning. That's an electric awning. Also has a door awning that covers your door. It's also that one you crank out. Window awnings too are a big plus, because you may be parked somewhere where you're getting a lot of sun, and you can pull those awnings out, help protect yourself from getting too much exposure inside your coach from the sun. Lots of storage, as I mentioned. This is built on a Freightliner chassis. So it's a raised rail chassis. Lots of storage, as I mentioned. You got the slide out tray, goes both directions. But if you notice up here, there's also he's got some storage up above the rails. But the nice thing about a raised rail chassis is you do have more storage and more pass-through storage area because of the way it's designed. Plus your floor, this is the floor of the coach, isn't resting on the main frame rails of your coach. So going down the road, the frame rails are going to be absorbing a little bit more of the shock, of the road shock. Then you don't feel that vibration inside your motorhome. You've got plenty of doors to access that storage. 50 amp service, there's your power cord. This is just an access to your tanks. Looks like that's got, not sure which tank that might be, probably your fresh water tank or your black tank, but anyway, it's there. The other thing I think that's I'm gonna make note of here too is that this does have dual furnaces. We'll see when we get on the other side, there's also another propane furnace, so you've got great heating, great system set up for batteries. You got your two chassis batteries down here, and then it's got four house batteries up above. Both of these have trays so you can pull them out, check them, look like they're pretty new batteries actually. And your inverter's in this compartment, another little storage compartment in there. I think this has a 2000 watt inverter, I believe. I'll have to double check that, but that looks like that's right, but don't hold me to it. Again, full body paint, Freightliner chassis. This is powered by a 350 horse turbo diesel. It's a Cummins diesel. Plenty of power to tow. Also, it's already set up for towing. You can pull your tow vehicle right up behind it, hook it up, and away you go. Side mount radiator. This is something a lot of people like, having the radiator over here rather than the back of your coach. It's a little easier to get into inside of your motor, the motor compartment. This is hydraulics for your leveling system. Does have automatic levelers that are hydraulic. Here's your wet bay, where your hookups for your sewer, hookups for your fresh water, so on and so forth. Even has an outside shower set up. Here's that other furnace exhaust that we were talking about. Having two furnaces gives you the ability to have two zones, so you can have a different temperature setting for a different part of the motorhome. So one section you might want a little warmer than the other, but you can see lots of storage. That's where your power cord goes through over here. huge propane tank. Got a large capacity propane. Looks like it's got alloy wheels, got the nice upgraded wheels. Well, this is the LTC model as well, so this is their higher end trim level. They made a couple of different versions of the Tradewinds, this being their fancier model. You can see the nice paint, and over here you can kind of get a better idea of the window awnings, how they work on this one too. So on those two big windows, you got awnings that come out. Another little storage compartment here also. Exhaust for your generators right here, generators up front. Housed right inside of here. Let's take a look inside. Yeah, before we go in, remember, if you have questions, 541-510-1017, Jim Beckler, so just give me a call and I'll be glad to help. Now, we just got this in, so we really even haven't had a chance to clean it up yet, but it's still very, very clean. It's going to be standing tall when we get done detailing it. We like to clean everything before it goes out of here too, so if you decide to buy this from us, we'll have somebody go through it just before it leaves the lot. We also check all the major appliances and make sure that all those are working well. But notice the easy cockpit. It's got nice wide seats, nice really comfortable seating, nice leather. This feels like it's the real deal here. It could be ultra leather, but either way, it's nice and comfortable and soft. The controls are easy to get to up here. It's got the Gen start up here. This one is equipped with an exhaust brake, which you'll like having. Really kind of helps slow you down going down those steep grades. Tilt and telescope on the wheels. A lot of conveniences to make this really a fun coach to drive. You'll really like the way this drives. Got a nice suspension and real quiet. One of the advantages of having a diesel pusher engine in the back, I don't have the engine noise up front. You really don't hear what's going on when you're accelerating. It's a little quieter up front. You can carry on a conversation without having to yell at each other. Looks like you got your electronics right here. DVD, and looks like it's got set up for satellite. So got some storage compartments here. Quite a bit of storage in this coach, actually. I like the wood, kind of a medium, not too dark, but not too light. It's dark enough to give it a nice rich look, almost a darker oak. Nice deep compartments here also. The sofa is a what they call a magic bed. Looks like it folds out, makes it into a sleeper. Very comfortable and easy to operate. Just folds out, and then on the opposite side over here we've got a nice rocker recliner. The table that folds out here also, that you could use for a little coffee nook or whatever. More storage up above. Looks like it's got all the books. See, it's really this is going to make somebody a nice motorhome. It's been well cared for, very clean, set up nice, good floor plan. Good decor. Should have two more chairs somewhere, probably fold out chairs that go with this. Kitchen area has got a nice little setup too. You got solid surface countertops, plenty of countertops. Sink covers help with that also. You can use these sink covers for additional workspace, or you got double sinks there. Makes it a little easier to do dishes. Storage underneath. Adjustable shelves up here too, which makes it nice, a little more versatile. Looks like it has a really nice microwave convection, a large convection oven. Three burner, I'm assuming, stovetop. Yeah, three burner stovetop. And this all folds back, so you can use this as a backsplash also while you're cooking. Again, a lot of drawers. good amount of storage. Even has a little paper towel holder right there. Larger capacity refrigerator with refrigerator and freezer separate. Looks like it has its own ice maker. Again, we're gonna clean this up for you. Everything gets clean before you take delivery of the motorhome. I like the fact that it does have, the way this is designed, is the floor plan. You've got storage. I mean, you have doors on both sides. It looks like this has a little lock that releases once you get it figured out how it works. Anyway, so you can close off the coach from the main part of the coach to your back bedroom area so you can have guests. If you don't have guests, you can close that off or wherever, or just leave it. But back here, you also have another door. So if you did have guests, you can have your bedroom area that's, you know, private. Both these sides slide. This one's locked down, but you get the idea. So it closes. So you do have privacy. This one comes equipped with a Splendid all-in-one combination washer and dryer. Handy to have, and then you got additional storage up here. Toilets in here. It's got a nice, looks like a fantastic fan vent in there. The window. Great shower. Large, looks like it has like a garden tub. Not a huge tub, but it'll hold water if you want to sit in there and wash your feet, or maybe you got children that go and like to take baths, they'd fit in there just fine. And of course it does have a shower as well. Having a skylight above there really lets in some natural light. Nice little sink back here. Medicine cabinet. And again, more drawers. Utilizing the storage really well. Bedroom area has lots of storage as well. Queen size walk around bed. I like the fact that you've got shelves on both sides, so you have nightstands with drawers here. Lights on both sides also. And having a window in the back makes it nice too. You can let in some fresh air. Big closet space, as well as additional closets here on both sides. Looks like this. These shelves are adjustable too. You could actually take those out if you wanted to. Same thing over here, adjustable shelves. Looks like the TVs are the later style LCDs. More storage. Even has a little laundry chute here. Great floor plan. Again, 2003 Tradewinds. This is the LTC model, so it's really the nice upgraded version. So if you're looking for a quality diesel motorhome that's you know, a little more affordable than what you might find, especially, you know, a lot less than what you're looking at a new or even a later model, this could be the one. It's very good condition, and I think you'll really appreciate once you see it up close. So again, give me a call if you have questions. It's Jim Beckler. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. Thanks.